It's often said there are four ingredients that go into prosciutto di Parma: Italian pork, sea salt, air, and thyme.
What an amazing place this is. So Vittorio, what makes prosciutto di Parma the king of the Italian hams?
Per i suoi valori, la sua storia, i suoi valori, la tradizione.
The important factors are history, tradition. It's an artisanal product and it's 100% natural.
Diciamo è da tantissimo tempo. Già
what he's saying is that prosciutto di Parma is very ancient because it was produced in Roman times, Etrurian times. However, it became officially prosciutto di Parma with the birth of the Consorzio in 1963.
Is it the same procedure as it was in the Roman times?
La produzione è intensiva.
All the basic elements are there.
Gli ingredienti sono la carne.
The ingredients are the hind legs of the pig, sea salt from the Mediterranean, a lot of thyme, and the climate.
So two ingredients and then the process behind it.
Prosciutto di Parma can only be made from specially bred pigs born and humanely raised in the hills surrounding Parma. They're fed grains, cereals, and sometimes whey left over for making Parmigiano Reggiano cheese.
First of all, the fresh legs go through a machine which prepares the fibers of the meat, sort of gives it a massage. And then they're salted because it's fresh meat and it needs to be preserved. They're salted with sea salt from the Mediterranean. Very often it comes from Sicily.
The pork legs are refrigerated for a week, then get another thin layer of salt.
And then it will go to the first phase, which we call the winter phase. And in this room, which is very cold and humid, there's a constant cycle of temperature.
Is this to replicate old school methods?
Yes, actually, once upon a time, everything used to be done following the seasons. And this is still reproduced nowadays, and that helps the salt to penetrate inside very slowly.
The most mysterious ingredient is the air. Windows are opened, and the Mediterranean winds that pass over the Apennine Mountains and through aromatic pines flows in.
After this is done, the hams are ready to be taken to the cellar for the final aging process.
The final ingredient is perhaps the rarest in today's world, thyme. After 6 to 7 months of curing, the hams are rubbed with pork fat to prevent them from drying too quickly.
They are greased with pork fat. This is called sugnatura in Italian. It softens the meat a little bit and it keeps the ham protected.
Each ham takes at least 400 days to cure, and some age up to 36 months. Finally, each ham gets the final sniff test. An inspector pierces it in several places with a horse bone needle and checks for scents of spoilage.
They have to smell it very quickly. It's a bit like being a sommelier because you need to be trained to do so, and it tells them if the ham has reached maturation, but also if there are any defects.
It's their indication whether it's a good ham or it's ready to go.
Yes, exactly.
Fascinating. Yeah.
If it passes the test, it gets branded with the Prosciutto di Parma 5-point crown.
They'll be fire branded and then they're ready to be commercialized.
Finally, the ham is ready to enjoy. Here in Parma, there's only one way to truly savor everything that went into the prosciutto, freshly cut into paper-thin slices.
Why mess with perfection?